cameras inside, we can run down the belt, take pictures, and make decisions about what's a pretty oyster. Take sizes, small, medium, and large, automatically kicks them out. The best view of this machine is from the very end, and we'll get them to start up again after I'm trying to explain this. This oyster sack starts as a tree somewhere in South America usually, and ends up making it into a burlap sack. Usually brings coffee or cocoa. Those are the two things he brings from America. This is a Colombian coffee sack. He comes over, we buy the sacks from the companies that import the coffee. We'll use the sack 10 or 15 times, and we'll sell it to crabbers. Crabbers are using a lot of their boxes, probably about 5 times, and they'll actually sell it to gardeners who use it as worm food. So it starts as a tree and it ends up right in the ground. Not very many things can you follow all of the like that. So these are actually coffee bean sacks, sometimes they're cocoa sacks. Oftentimes when we wash up, we find cocoa and coffee on the floor and it's just rubbed in from the sack. It doesn't affect the product at all. Having coffee run up in this oyster shell doesn't bother it at all.
Is it getting the oyster?
No. Oysters come with their own packaging. I mean, they'll never open while they're in the sack. They only open in water, so it works out well. Here, we take the sack and put it in there. We weigh the sack to make sure that it's at least 100 pounds. Putting it on the belt, the oysters, we wash them off. They have lots of mud and silt kicked on them. That is a low pressure wash that gets the mud off, and then we grade them. Once they're graded, we decide on the food after we start up again so you can get whatever film. The best view of this machine is all the way at the end looking back to see how it works.
How many people work here?
We have about 80 people that work here right now. We used to run two 10-hour shifts. Today we're doing one 10-hour shift. We're running a little bit.